Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. In second part of steam engine, we are going to make this six number of parts in today's part two. So I hope you like it. So let's start to make this six number of parts. Here the next part of steam engine is centrifugal pump bearing. So let's start with right plane exit. And let me choose here circle. We want to create a cylindrical part, so let's draw a circle with origin and let's define diameter 20 millimeter. Go to feature and extrude, and extrude up to 13 millimeter and make it reverse direction. Okay. Now select the back surface sketch, choose circle and select this point and draw a bigger circle. Right click, exit. Now you can rotate according to yours, and let me define this 28 millimeter. Now see, now let's extrude it again, and this time we will extrude 19 millimeter. This is the requirement. Okay, now it's time to cut this one. So select the back surface sketch, choose your circle and draw a circle, and let's keep the diameter 22 millimeter. Okay, and select here, go to feature, extruded cut, and we want to cut inside up to 6 millimeter. Okay, that's it. This is the depth. Select the inside face sketch, choose circle and draw a circle. And let me define the diameter 18 millimeter. That's it. Again go to feature, select extruded cut, and we want to make one more cut, but this time let's keep depth 10 millimeter. Okay, come front face sketch, choose circle and here draw a big small circle. And let's keep this diameter 10 millimeter. That's it. Now this time select extruded cut and keep through all, end condition through all, so it will cut throughout. Okay, that's it. Let me choose fillet 0.05 millimeter and I'll choose this one. Okay, and I'll define this material plastic satin finish. It looks vibrant and it looks nice color basically. And choose here a steam engine assembly. Go back. Okay, let's save this part. Centrifugal pump bearing. That's it. Let's save this one and move for the next part. Now here let's start to create the our seventh part, centrifugal pump cover. This is very important part. So let's start with front plane sketch, and let me choose here line and start with origin point. I'll draw a geometry and close. Directly choose smart dimensions, and we will define it 28 millimeter. This length 14 millimeter. Now let me define the overall length 47.5 millimeter. 35 millimeter. Keep both 5 millimeter. Now you can see the drawing is fully defined. So just go to feature, select revolve boss base, and select this bottom line as axis of revolution. So you will find this option. Keep blind and angle 360 degree. Okay, see, choose fillet, keep radius 5 millimeter and select this inside edge. Okay, that's fine. Now I want to create one countersunk hole here for M12 screw, so I'll choose this face, hole wizard, go to ISO standard, socket ISO 1046 standard, and this one keep M12, and we will define the condition of M12 screw, so keep normal. This is actually, we are going to create a hole for screw. Keep M12, and this conditions, let me choose 14 millimeter, then here 26 millimeter, 90 degree 180, and this one keep throughout. Check the position and select this center point, press escape key. Now see, it's going to create throughout. Okay, that's it. Select this face, sketch, choose circle and draw one circle. Take the normal position and select this circle for construction purpose in your left hand side. Okay, now see, and let me define this angle, radius, diameter, sorry, 80 millimeter exit. And I'll choose this face, hole wizard, and again I want to create one countersink hole, ISO standard hexagon same, and this time we will choose M6, and the hole size we will define it here 6.5, show, and this length 7.5 90 degree, keep throughout position, and I'll select this position. Even you can select, but we will choose only one. Select OK. Now see, circular pattern here, select this cutout, or even you can directly choose from here, and here parameters, select any circular face, see 360 degree, and we need to make six number of instances, six number of patterns, so we choose here six number, and make sure it keep equal spacing, otherwise if you will change this angle, it see, better to keep equal angle, equal spacing. Okay, now that's it. Let me hide this, go to material, go to plastic satin finish, and let me define green. Save this part. Part number 7. Centrifugal pump cover. Let's save this one and let's move for the next part. Let's do the next part, centrifugal pump pulley. So let's start with front plane, a sketch, choose here circle and draw a circle from origin point, smart dimension, and let me define 108 millimeter. Select extruded boss base, and I want to extrude up to 12 millimeter, but make sure it is mid plane, and condition keep mid plane. Now select the back surface, sketch, draw one circle here, and let's keep the diameter 98 millimeter. Now select extruded cut, and we want to keep depth this 3.5 millimeter only, but keep angle 40 degree. See, select OK. Now see, now we want to mirror this one. So how we will do this one? Choose right plane, mirror, and select from here. See, front plane we selected, features to mirror, select extruded cut. See, you can see the preview. Select OK. Now it is mirror. Choose fillet 20 millimeter and select this inside edge in both side. OK, that's it. Now select this face sketch, exit, and select this outer face sketch normal, and let me define a circle here and keep the diameter 28 millimeter. Now we want to extrude. Now this one actually we want to extrude, but let's keep 19 millimeter. Make reverse direction. See, okay, that's it. This is what our requirement. Select this backside sketch normal, and here we want to make relief hole. So first what we have to do, choose circle and draw a circle, and draw one small circle here. Select exit. Now select this center circle for construction purpose. Choose smart dimension and let's define this 60 millimeter, and this smaller circle 16 millimeter. That's perfect. Choose circular sketch pattern and select this center point, and here pattern to entities, choose this circle, and here you can give 360 degree equal spacing, and 6 number of holes we like to make, or leave as it is. We will make one only. Select extruded cut and keep end condition through all. Okay, now here let's choose the fillet, but let me correct this one. Keep 15 millimeter. 15 millimeter is better for choosing chamfer. Chamfer, keep 1 millimeter 45 degree. This uncheck this one and select this face. Now see, and keep arrow outward direction. Okay, that's it. Now it's time to make multiple number of patterns, so choose circular pattern. Here select any circular face, here choose chamfer, 360 degree, 6 number of equal pattern, select OK. We need to choose the hole also, extruded cut, this hole also we need to select. Now try, that's it. Look, we created multiple number of patterns. Now select this face sketch number. Now here we need to create a keyhole, so for that let me define the circle, center line, up to this line. Exit. Let's define this one 14 millimeter the outer diameter, and distance from here to here 8.4 millimeter, 2.5 millimeter, and the same distance from bottom, 2.5 millimeter. That's it. Choose trim entities here. Choose power trim, drag it with left mouse, trim. Okay. Now select, go to feature and select extruded cut. You want to make a keyhole here, so keep end condition throughout. Through all, okay. See. Now we need to create a V groove for the belt. So how we will do this one? Let me choose right plane, sketch, normal. Let me define first center line. Select here line. Select outer line. Connect. Exit. Now choose center line and select these two edges and make relation symmetric. That's it. Okay. Now let me define this one. Seven millimeter. Let me choose the angle 40 degree. Now select here center line. Select this, make sure it is horizontal, the smart dimension, and the bottom line from this center point 46.5 millimeter. See, this is our requirement. And go to select revolve cut. Select this line as axis of revolution. See, keep blind and 360 degree. Okay. See, this is the V belt groove. It looks nice. I'll choose some chamfer, 1 and 45 degree. We will choose this back side. Okay. Now it's time to add some color. So how we will do this one? Go to appearance. And we will add some color like blue. Not blue. I decided to keep this 129 by 0, 129 255. This is the looks nice. Save. Now let me save this part. Centrifugal pump cover. Oh, sorry, we saved this one as a cover, but it is actually pulley. So just save it as a pulley. Select replace. Or let me save. Pulley. That's it. Now here let's start to make the next part, centrifugal pump housing. This is a very important part of pump and engine. So let's start with front plane sketch, and we will choose first center circle, and let's draw a circle with origin point. That's it. I'll choose here center line. Exit. Select the line and start from this bottom point up to, draw any kind of shape. exit. Now see, again choose the line, start from here, then touch with this circle. Okay, let's start with dimension. Outer diameter 95 millimeter, 38 millimeter, and 50 millimeter, 14 millimeter, and distance from here to here, this one 59.5 millimeter. That's it. Now this center distance, we will make 30 millimeter. Okay, everything is defined. So let me choose some corner fillet. This one keep 10 millimeter. Select this point and this line. We will do some little exercise. Choose trim entities, power trim, and trim this one. Trim this portion also. Okay, now try fillet. Keep 10 millimeter and select this corner. You can see the preview, and the same thing we have to do this corner also. Choose OK. Now reduce, make 4 millimeter and select this corner. Okay. Now here we need to change this one, 4 millimeter. Okay, this length make 10 millimeter so that you will get some gap here. Okay, now let's try to mirror. So select this, all lines, circles, and everything, and mirror against this vertical line. Okay, now see, choose trim entity and power trim. So trim this one. Now see, this is fully defined. And one more thing, now everything is okay. We defined all the dimensions. So select extruded boss base and extrude up to 22 millimeter. Choose here OK, and let me define some material. I'll choose plastic, satin finish green. OK, now select this face, this sketch, choose circle and draw here a circle, and let me define this diameter 70 millimeter. And go to feature and select extruded cut. We want to create a hole here, and we will make the depth 18 millimeter. Okay, look, now go back, sketch. Now here we want to extrude some part, so select circle and draw one circle from midpoint or origin point, and let's keep the diameter 28 millimeter. Go to feature and select here extruded boss base, and we will extrude up to 7 millimeter. Okay, choose fillet. I'll choose here symmetric 4 millimeter radius and select this edge. Okay, now select this face sketch, and here we want to create a hole, so let me choose circle and define this radius, a diameter, keep diameter 20 millimeter, and select extruded cut. And we want to make the hole throughout, so choose here end condition through all. Okay, now see, that's it. Let me choose some chamfer and choose here chamfer 2 by 45 degree and select this one corner. We are not able to any pop up, so we have to select one by one. Choose OK. That's it. Now select this top face sketch. Here we want to make some tapped hole. So first of all, we need to create one center line. Now exit. Now select this face hole wizard and choose here straight tap. We will choose okay matrix, and matrix is enough. Bottoming tapped hole, and okay, this is the same dimension. I made by 1.25 millimeter. End condition, we will keep some dimensions 29.275 millimeter. This is your end condition. Okay, then comes down. This is also the keep the same thing. So go to position and place, take the normal position, place here, press escape key, choose dimension and select dimension from here to this corner. We calculated this one 7.7585 millimeter. You can see the preview, it's going to overlap from here. Okay, that's it. Now we want to make some hole here, so select this face sketch, choose circle and draw one circle and select for construction purpose. This is for reference purpose. Okay, we want to create some hole here, tapped hole, so we need this one. Keep diameter 80 millimeter. Okay, now simply exit. Now here we need to make some tapped hole for screw, so select this face and choose hole wizard, and here we take the normal position and choose a straight tap. Keep standard matrix, and here bottoming tapped hole we need to make comes down. This is the same M6 by 1, and this size no need to show, and blind okay, we will keep 15 millimeter, and this one keep as it is. Go to position and select this top position. You can see the arrow, see this, take escape, delete, and again choose this star point and put select this circle which we selected for in construction line. Okay, now we put here, select okay. Now see, if you want to see the threads, let me choose option document property detailing and select here shaded cosmetic thread. Now you can see, you can see the shaded cosmetic threads. Now let me make multiple number of patterns, so choose circular pattern and here select M6 and here select any circular face. So I'll choose this one circular face. Keep 360 degree because the full circle is 360, and 6 number of instances, 6 number of patterns we would like to make, and keep equal spacing. Okay, see, now let's hide this all construction line. Now we need to make some hole here also. Just choose bottom, take the normal position, hole wizard, And here also we will choose countersunk hole, because we need to create some countersunk hole here. A standard keep my isometric, or let me choose ISO standard. CTSK 70461, this is the perfect. And here we will choose M8 hole. Normal size, select show customize, 6 millimeter, 8 millimeter, and this one remaining as it is. And blind keep 20 millimeter. Take the position and draw parallel to this center point, the same way did this side. Just choose the center point and now press escape key, and let's define 8 millimeter. The same here, okay. Now we need to create one more relation. Select the center point of this hole and select the midpoint of this line. Horizontal, okay. Now it's defined. Select this point and horizontal. Now this drawing is fully defined. Now you can see the preview. Select OK. Now the countersunk hole is created for the screw. Isometric view, trimetric view. So this is our simple housing, centrifugal pump housing. So now let's save this housing. Part number 9, centrifugal pump housing, save. Here the next part is centrifugal pump impeller. So let's start to create impeller. Choose front plane, sketch, and let me define two circles. So draw two circles. Inner one keep for construction purpose, so choose here for construction. See, now let's define. Keep outer diameter 66 millimeter and inner one 33 millimeter, okay. And here choose center line and define vertical and horizontal center line, and let's define the angle. We will keep this angle 25 degree. Choose your circle and draw one circle from this midpoint, 10 millimeter, okay. Now select 3-point arc. Select this one point, second point here, exit. Now let's define this radius. Keep almost 19.8 millimeter or 20 millimeter. Now select both the circle and arcs. It is not coincide with this circle. It's already coincide, I think. Now create relation tangent. Now see. And one more relation we need to create. Select this point and this circle and make coincident relation. Okay, this is important relation. Choose trim entity. Choose power trim and trim these two faces. Just press left key and drag. See, it's simple. Okay, now we need to make first multiple number of patterns. So Here in parameters, choose this center point, and entities to pattern, select these two circles and arcs, and here define 360 equal spacing, and we need 6 number of patterns, so okay, that's it. Now again choose 3 point arc, select this point up to this point, one more, draw from this point to this point, exit. Now first select these two arcs, make tangent relation, and define this one radius 5 millimeter. Okay, now here select this line and this arc and create one relation tangent. This is very important relation. Now that's it, choose power trim and trim this one. Okay, now it's time to make multiple number of patterns, so choose your circular pattern. This is very complicated if you while you are drawing, so make each and every relation perfect. Here select this pattern 1, 2 equal spacing 360 degree, keep, and this is your center point, origin point, keep. Okay, that's it. Now again choose trim entity and trim unnecessary portion. Delete unnecessary if you feel any. This is just simply blade, so no need to make any exact dimensions or something like this. Okay, trim entity, power trim, and let me trim this. Select here center point arc, start from this center point from here to here, exit. Merge, it's now met. Now this is your main requirement for the blade. Now let me extrude. Select this face and extrude up to 10 millimeter. Okay. Now again we want to make some hole here, so select this face, sketch, and draw two circles. Outer one 33 millimeter and inner one 16 millimeter. The center one we will extrude, cut. So select extruded cut and cut only up to 5 millimeter. Okay, that's it. Choose fillet 2 millimeter. Select this inside. No, better let me choose one by one. Select OK. Again choose fillet 1 millimeter. We are looking some. Okay. fillet 1 millimeter and select this face. See, okay. Now some faces are still balanced, it seems. So you can directly select 1 millimeter, okay. Now that's it. And the last one, 2 millimeter, and select this corner and this upper one, okay. Now here we will make some hole for a tap for threading. So choose hole wizard. Select straight tap. Matrix bottoming tapped hole, and size is M8 by 1 inch. 8 millimeter is sufficient. And blind, let me keep 19 millimeter better. Choose position and select this center point. Select OK. Now go to option, document property, choose here detailing and select cosmetic thread. Now this is your tapped hole. And this is the ampler. Let's save this as it is. Centrifugal impeller, or you can write centrifugal pump impeller. That's it. Now here let's make the next part, centrifugal pump shaft. So I'll start with right plane, a sketch, circle, and let me draw a circle with 10 millimeter diameter. Choose smart dimension and keep diameter 10 millimeter and select extruded boss base. And keep end condition mid plane, 69 millimeter length. Select isometric view. Okay. Now that's fine. Now here we want to make some grooves. So how we will do this one? Select this face. Choose this sketch. Now select this face and convert entity. Again select one more face, circle. And let me draw this diameter. Millimeter. Now select feature and extruded cut boss base, and blind, keep blind, and we want to cut up to 2 millimeter thickness. Here in from choose offset 10 millimeter. See, it's going outward, so just select reverse. See, this is what we like. Okay. It's not able to see. Sorry. We want to cut actually. Delete and select this sketch and choose extruded cut. Now select offset 10 millimeter reverse, and this is also to this side outward direction. select OK. Now see, that's what we like. Now the same thing we will do it for this side. A sketch, convert entity in outer circle converted. Draw one more circle and let's keep the diameter 8 mm. And go to feature and select extruded cut. We want to cut up to 1.5 mm offset, 5 mm. Keep reverse. Now see the arrow, we don't want this side, we want opposite direction, so select this side. See both opposite direction, okay. Now see, that's nice. Chamfer 0.5 degree, 45 degree. Select both the end. Okay. Now the chamfer also created and everything. Now choose front plane, a sketch, normal. And here we want to create some keyhole. So let me choose. Okay. Straight slot, select this center point, choose your line, connect this line and delete this. Okay, undo the process and choose trim entity and trim this one. Okay, now let's define 25.5 millimeter and a radius 1.5 millimeter. Okay, and select origin point and this line and make relation. No, let me choose both the points horizontal. Okay, let's define the gap 3 mm, 1.5. Now it is fully defined. You can see here. Now select extruded cut. Reverse direction. Select here offset entities. 3.2 millimeter. See 3.2 millimeter from the position of front axis, and here you can keep through all. Okay, that's it. See, we created a groove here. Now I'll try to insert some cosmetic thread. I'll choose this edge, machine thread, blind here, seven millimeter. Okay, now choose option documents property and here choose detailing cosmetic shaded thread. Okay, now you can see the threads. This is simple. So this is the shaft. Actually it should be here a standard thread, but okay, we don't have that much time to create. So now let's save this part. This is the part number 11. Centrifugal pump shaft.